salary was $250,000 a year, right? And he did the pulmonary specialization and he finished it, and 2 months later COVID came up.
COVID came.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
So basically he finished his pulmonary specialization.
Okay.
And as soon as he finished it, the whole world was hit with a pandemic where your lungs are getting affected.
Yeah.
So his salary in one night, it went from 250,000 to 450,000.
Oh my god. Yeah.
Now some people might say it's a miracle.
Someone says that it is a miracle, but what is his opinion?
Hello Indrajit, how are you?
I'm great, and how are you, sir?
I'm good. I'm really excited to talk to you today. How
yes,
have you
after
been?
A long time.
Yeah, it is after a long time. How have you been?
Everything is fine, and fortunately there is no COVID cases right now in my locality, so it is okay. But I heard about that news that the new variant Omicron has been increasing. So we have to be more cautious about that.
Yeah, definitely. We do. I think scientists have suggested that this should, like, the overall corona pandemic will subside, because after a while the virus cannot mutate anymore. It gets weaker. Even though it gets more harmful, its power to transmit from one person to another reduces. That's how it works.
Okay.
Right? Because if you improve on something, you will lose out on something else. Just like us. Like if we improve, let's say we get bigger muscles, that will compromise our flexibility.
Okay.
Right? The same way, if we gain a lot of weight, we lose our speed. Right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's like when the virus gets deadlier, it reduces it, or it kind of affects its ability to transmit faster.
Okay. So vice versa, like that.
Yeah, same way. So they are saying hopefully by the summer of 2022, which is I think 5 or 6 months down the line, we should be corona free. The world should be corona free.
Wow, that's really nice. So
yeah, but let me remind you. Let me remind you, that's exactly what they said when corona actually started. Right? Weren't we told that, okay, we only have to stay at home for 2 weeks, 15 days, then it came to 2 months, then it went to 3 months, then it went to 6 months.
Then it is going on.
Yeah, exactly. So I don't completely blame them, but I don't trust them. And because there are so many variables, a lot of things can go wrong. But as long as we follow all the rules, everybody gets vaccinated. Obviously, there's no vaccination for Omicron. But we have to be safe. We have to make sure that we don't get out of the house unnecessarily or expose ourselves to a possible Omicron affected patient. But anyway, let's not talk about that. We are hearing about COVID anyway on the news and everything. So let's talk about something else. I really like your jacket, by the way. Is it really cold
Wow.
over there?
I recently bought it.
Is it really cold over there?
Yeah, around 12 degrees.
Oh my god, everyone I'm talking to is wearing jackets and I'm feeling hot over here. I'm thinking of switching on the AC.
Oh, what is the temperature there in Mumbai?
27 and 30. Like the average is 27 to 30.
Okay, that's a...
So in the afternoon, I'm actually sweating.
Okay. So the Mumbai... So Mumbai cars especially don't feel winter.
No, it's chota summer. I keep saying this, it's chota summer, not winter.
Oh.
I think at night it gets around 18 degrees, so it's pleasant, it's comfortable. 18? I don't think it's 18 also. I think it's somewhere around 20, 21. That is the lowest it has gone, at least in the last couple of weeks. But hopefully we'll have a proper winter soon.
Yeah. We hope so also, because you are seeing that your learners that wearing jackets and you are not.
Yeah, it's fine. I understand. But the thing is, I'm miserable here because it's not cold enough, hot. But the learners are miserable everywhere because it's too cold where they are. It's 5 degrees, it's 8 degrees, it's 12 degrees.
Sometimes.
the grass is always greener on the other side, right? Yeah, anyway. So today we're talking about miracles. Are you interested in the topic?
Yeah, it is an interesting topic. I have gone through this topic.
Okay. So, Indraji, tell me, do you believe in miracles?
Yes, I believe in miracle, but it did not happen till now. I'm waiting for that.
It hasn't happened with me.
It hasn't happened. Okay.
Yeah. It hasn't happened to you, obviously. The best way to kind of...
Have you experienced with it?
Have I experienced a miracle? That's a good question. Now, the weird thing is, miracles, it's very difficult to define a miracle in someone's life, right? Because,
it is very
you
deep.
Know, yeah, I think miracles, coincidence, luck, they're all very closely related, for me at least, right? Mm-hmm. So I'll just give you a story. Recently, I went out with a couple of friends on this weekend, and I was talking to one of them who is becoming a doctor, right? And his elder brother, he was a general doctor, general physician, and he was in charge of basically, you know how when we get a cold, we go see a doctor, right?
Okay, physician like that.
So he was a general physician. This is pre-COVID. He was having a conversation with his dad. The doctor was having a conversation with his dad. And his dad said, why don't you do a specialization in pulmonary something, right? Mm. And pulmonary means lungs.
Lungs, yeah. Lungs related. I read that time in biology.
Anything related to lungs. And he's like, okay, fine. I'll just do it. It's fine. And at that time, his salary was, he lives in the US. So his salary was $250,000 a year, right? And he did the pulmonary specialization. And he finished it. And 2 months later, COVID came up.
COVID came.
Yeah.
Oh my God.
So basically he finished his pulmonary specialization.
Okay.
And as soon as he finished it, the whole world was hit with a pandemic where your lungs are getting affected.
Yeah.
So his salary in one night, it went from 250,000 to 450,000.
Oh my God. Yeah.
Now some people might say it's a miracle.
Someone says that it is a miracle, but what is his opinion?
Well, obviously, anyone would be surprised if something so crazy happens, right?
Yeah, sure.
Imagine you're a doctor for like a good 5-7 years. And in that 1 year, you decide to do something like a specialization. And then suddenly everyone in the world needs your help, right?
True.
So it can be a miracle.
You suggested him to do as a pulmonary or anyone.
No. So I was talking to a friend of mine.
Okay.
His elder brother is the one who did the pulmonary specialization.
Okay.
So his elder brother, who is in the US, was talking to his father.
Okay, I see. I got it. Oh my God. That's
really
crazy.
Yeah, and the father didn't, obviously no one knew COVID was coming up, right? It was just a random thing. And to do a specialization, it's not like you finish it in 1 month. It takes a really long time, especially if you're a doctor. So,
yeah.
Like, I don't know if it was one year specialization or 2 years, but it's just crazy that as soon as he got done, COVID came up. It's not even like while he was doing it, it came up, or he started doing it and COVID came up. So when I heard that story, I was laughing and I was just wondering how crazy is this world that luck and coincidence and sometimes miracles happen and you don't even know why they happen. Like, I'm sure you've heard a lot of stories of people struggling with diseases, with a lot of fatal diseases. Not fatal, sorry, terminal diseases. And
even
then
coma.
Yeah, exactly. Someone's in a coma for 20 years and then suddenly one day they just wake up.
Yeah. So, and I recently heard a story that a woman was in a coma situation, but when and the doctors found that she is pregnant. And she delivered a baby, then she come into the light. I mean, come into the sense.
Say she was pregnant while she went into the coma.
Yeah. And right? doctors found that. And so doctors tried to deliver her baby. Then the operation was successful. Then suddenly, coincidentally, she was out from the coma situation.
Yeah. So you can say she woke up from the coma.
Hmm.
As soon as she delivered the baby, she woke up from the coma and she was healthy and she was perfectly fine.
Hmm.
So, you know, we don't know a lot of things about the human body technically.
True.
Even though we've been alive for so long and we've done so many studies and there are so many specialists, we don't know. We know a lot. We don't know everything about the human body. Let's be safe and say that. We don't know everything about the human body. Now, Inderjeet, I'm sure you read the newspaper or you follow the news.
Yes, some way.
Right? I'm sure over the years, there was this one random story that you read in the newspaper or someone told you, and you were not sure whether you should believe it or not. Can you think of that story? Can you come up with a story? Of a miracle or a coincidence or something weird or magical.
It was... I heard about a story that a little boy of a very poor family got lottery. That the amount is...
Won the lottery.
He won the lottery. Amount is 1 crore.
Wow.
And his father was slaughterer of
butcher.
Yeah. Okay, butcher. Yeah.
I thought his father was slaughtered, and I was like, oh my god.
Oh,
you said his father was slaughtered. I'm like, oh my god, that sounds so bad.
Yeah.
So
okay.
Bad for a second.
So that is called butcher, right?
Yes, a person who cuts meat like chicken, cow.
Yes.
It's called a butcher. Slaughter basically means like I slaughtered that person. That means I killed him. Like I
killed. Okay. I see. It is a big word.
Yeah. So I think you were trying to say slaughterer, but slaughter is a little dark. It's a little negative.
Dark word.
So butcher negative. Is the technical term.
Technical term. Butcher. Okay.
Yeah. But a butcher works in a slaughterhouse.
Okay. Butcher works in a slaughterhouse. Okay.
Yeah, because that's where they slaughter the animals.
Mm-hmm.
They kill the animals. Okay.
So I think that winning a lottery is a really miracle. Is a.
I mean, it's lucky, but is it a miracle though?
I think that it is. Yeah, it is very lucky situation. He's very lucky, but no. So we can't say it is a miracle, right?
Yeah, because see now, even if we have a lucky draw, okay, let's say you come to my birthday party and there's a lucky draw. I'll put 1,000 numbers in a bowl, okay, and one person will win the lottery or will win the lucky draw. Now, this has more to do with luck than it has to do with miracles, because someone has to win, right? Someone even if the odds are 1 to 1,000, that means one person from 1,000 will win. That one person will be someone. It has to be someone.
Okay.
Right? So it all comes down to luck. Who gets the best luck and gets that 1 to 1,000 lucky draw ticket?
Someone has to be winner. Has to be the winner.
Someone has to win it, or someone has to, someone has to win that. Exactly. So a lot of people say, oh, then what are the odds of winning a lottery? Right. That's when negative people are talking. But an optimist will say that, okay, my odds are 1 to 1,000, but someone has to win, right?
True.
So if 1,000 people don't take the ticket because the odds are 1 to 1,000, then no one wins.
So that is not a game.
Math and probability, but also luck. So I don't think that would count as a miracle. Although a miracle, you know, a miracle is something like someone has a disease and it can't be treated. Right? And his or her family has put in all the money that they have. They've sold the house, they've sold the cars,
land. They've
sold all the jewelry, land, you know, and then they still can't afford the treatment, and then suddenly the patient is treated, or suddenly like something happens, or
suddenly someone donated money for that.
Again, that is luck, right? Like, it's not a miracle.
I see.
A miracle is something like, let's say you lose a finger and then the finger grows back. That is a miracle because we don't know how.
Unknowingly, surprisingly, okay.
Yeah. When it comes to money, and mostly also, it is just luck.
And miracle should be positive, right? In a positive way.
Yeah. Miracle, not miracle.
Miracle.
Miracles, yeah.
Miracle, okay.
Yeah. Okay, Indrajit, I think the session's about to get over. Do you have any questions for me?
Yeah, one question. It is a really nice to meet you after a long time. And so something happened in a negative way to anyone, then what is called that? And that is called bad luck.
Bad luck, yeah.
Okay. And it was a great session as usual. You are so energetic person. Thank you.
Same. Thank you so much. I think the session is about to get over, so I'll just say bye. It was very nice to see you, and hopefully we'll have more sessions.
Yeah, again. Sure.